I installed Elementary OS on my new laptop 6 months ago. After using Elementary OS for some time, I would like to share my thoughts on this Linux distro. I will start with why and how I installed Elementary OS alongside Windows 10. I will tell you about my first impression right after the installation of Elementary OS. And then I will go into more details explaining what I like or dislike about Elementary OS. Finally, I will point out a few things which are worth mentioning. They are neutral for me, but they may be crucial for you. Let's get started. I installed Elementary OS alongside Windows 10, which was pre-installed on my Acer Swift 1 laptop. I used Gparted to shrink the Windows partition and then installed Elementary OS on the newly created free space. It was the EFI installation. Elementary OS installed fine, and I can boot into Elementary OS or Windows 10 through the group menu without any problems. The Elementary OS installer is reliable, intuitive to use, and has all the necessary tools. So no complaints on this side. Elementary OS is not new for me. I installed Elementary OS Loki on my wife's laptop 3 years ago. Loki worked really well, so I was excited to try Elementary OS Uno. Right after the installation, I had a positive impression of Uno. All hardware, including Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, worked out of the box. Moreover, unlike some other distros, it also scaled well on my 13-inch 1080p screen. I was also pleased to see a lot of improvements since Loki. The desktop and the Elementary apps are more polished now. The apps feel even more integrated into the desktop ecosystem. App Center seems to work faster than before. I felt very happy that I installed Elementary OS and not Debian XFCE that I usually choose for low specs laptops. But after using Elementary OS Uno for some time, my positive impression about this OS started to deteriorate. But before going into negatives, let me list what I liked in Elementary OS. Elementary OS is beautiful. This is probably the number one reason people install Elementary OS. I also really like that this beauty doesn't come with the cost of speed. Being beautiful, Elementary OS is also pretty snappy on low specs computers. This is the hardware I run Elementary OS on. Elementary OS based on Ubuntu 18.04 LTS. And this simplifies many things. First, the LTS base guarantees more stability. Second, even if some problems arise, it is easy to find solution online because of the huge Ubuntu user base. Third, almost all third-party apps have a dev package tailored for Ubuntu, so finding and installing software in Elementary OS is also easy. Elementary OS is the only OS that makes me like minimalism. I usually need many features and a lot of settings. That's why Plasma 5 is my favorite desktop ever. However, the simplicity of Elementary OS somehow makes me relaxed. I probably would not be able to use Elementary OS 10 hours a day, 7 days a week, but as a laptop OS that is not used every day, it is really good for me. The menu is large and easy to navigate with a touchpad. There is also a search bar that makes opening apps even easier. You can also use the search bar to find some settings right from the menu. Dock is also very useful. You can pin the most frequently used apps to the dock. By default, the dock is auto-hiding, which is perfect for a laptop. You can quickly glance at the shortcuts by pressing the super key. These shortcuts can be modified in the settings, and using shortcuts is pretty handy on a laptop. I also think it is really good for new users to name application with names that indicate what they do. Files, code, music, videos, photos as the standard Elementary apps. Elementary OS is also the only distro that provides a real picture-in-picture mode. If you still have not tried, watch my video on how to use the picture-in-picture mode in Elementary OS. I also appreciate the multitasking view of Elementary OS. It provides a nice overview of the open apps. You can easily switch between desktop from here, and you can move apps across desktops. Settings options are minimal, but they provide all the essential options. Moreover, I was surprised to find the firewall option in the settings. Not many Linux distros include an option to enable firewall in such a simple way. By the way, if you're thinking about whether you need a firewall in Linux, watch the video you see on the card right now. It will give you an answer. I was also pleased to find the housekeeping tab that allows you to enable automatic cleaning of temporary files and trash. There are also many other small cool features ElementaryOS provides. For example, I like that files, terminal, and code open in the last closed state. Now let me introduce you some less positive things about ElementaryOS. Not everything I'm going to describe should be classified as a disadvantage, but some issues of ElementaryOS are worth considering before you install it. And we start with the major problems. The first problem I experienced was the mail app. I use two-factor authentication for my Gmail account. But not only mail doesn't support two-factor authentication, you also need to enable less secure apps in the Gmail settings to make mail work with it. So, mail is not the most secure email client. I suggest you to use a web interface for email work or Thunderbird instead. Similarly to mail, Epiphany web browser is also a weak app. For example, it fails to play some full HD videos. The video player just freezes every 2-3 seconds. Epiphany is also in general slower than Firefox, and it also lacks many extensions, so I replaced it with Firefox. I also do not like the concept of removing the minimize button and keeping only close and maximize buttons. The elementary team argues that apps would close and open instantly and even better because they would save their state before closing, but this applies only to the elementary apps. Other apps won't behave this way. So I added the minimize button. If you also need the minimize button, watch my video on 15 things to do after installing ElementaryOS. There is one more thing where ElementaryOS is too innovative. They changed the tray, so many third-party apps won't have tray icons. For example, I use Dropbox and I prefer to see its icon in the tray to know when it syncs. But you will not see the Dropbox icon in the elementary tray by default. It is possible to enable tray icons for Dropbox, Skype, and other third-party apps, but it requires some extra steps. Again, I showed how to do that in my video on 15 things to do after installing ElementaryOS. See the link in the description. The same day I installed ElementaryOS, I noticed that the cursor is not always in the password field at the login screen. So you cannot just start typing the password. You need to use the mouse or touchpad to navigate to the password field and tap there to be able to enter the password and log in the system. This is annoying. I also have some problems with using Suspend. Suspend works fine, but often 10-20 minutes after waking up, Wi-Fi connection drops and the only way to reconnect is to reboot the system. Speaking about connections, I usually disable Bluetooth because I seldom use it. But I noticed that sometimes it turns on itself after logout and login. It is not a big deal to disable it, but it is not how the system should work. Because Suspend doesn't work very well, I shut down my laptop almost every time I finish using it. Unfortunately, the shutdown is slow sometimes. It is annoying because when I'm on the go, I want to shut down my computer quickly and go, but I have to wait until I see that the system has turned off. Also, the camera app stopped recognizing my webcam after some time. When I installed ElementaryOS, it worked fine, but probably after some update it stopped working. I installed Cheese, another app for webcam, and it works fine, so the issue is definitely in the camera app. I also hate that files have the same view for all folders. You cannot have an icon view for the pictures folder and the list view for the documents folder. This is a problem of many file managers, and I don't understand why such a key feature is not implemented even in GNOME desktop. Multiple windows do not work on click and dock. If you have, for example, two LibreOffice documents open, they will be united under one icon in dock. You can barely see that with the indicator in the dock. When you click on the icons, it will open the last open window of LibreOffice. The second click will minimize that LibreOffice window. But it will never open the other LibreOffice window. Because of that, I often even didn't notice that I had two windows open. In other desktops, you are usually presented with both windows on a click. In elementary, To see multiple windows, you need to either use the right click or multitasking view. There are also some small issues that I can complain about, but it is possible to live with them. Files, the file manager, works with a single click to open files and folders. This concept is used in some Linux distros, but I do not get it. I need a single click to select and double click to open a file or a folder. So I disable the single click for files. Watch my video on things to do after installing Elementary OS for instructions. Searching files freezes sometimes. I believe it is because it indexes new files on the first open. It is also sensitive to typos. If you misspell a file name, it may not work. For example, it finds a file word count, but it fails to find the same file if you type words count. So you can use search, but it is not perfect. Photos doesn't play GIF animations. It just opens it as an image using the first image from the animation. I solved this problem by opening GIFs in Firefox. Terminal uses natural Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V copy-paste shortcuts. I understand that it may be better for new users, but these shortcuts are not standard for Terminal app. I am used to traditional Ctrl-Shift-C and Ctrl-Shift-V, and I believe new users should learn them too, so I disable the natural copy-paste in Terminal. When you make an application full screen, it is moved to a new desktop. I do not understand this behavior and I find it annoying. Why can't this app just stay on the same desktop and go full screen? My final wish to improve Elementary OS would be to have a dark theme included by default. Moreover, I would like to have an option to change themes, because these are the only appearance settings in Elementary OS by default. I would like to list a few more things which I believe are worth mentioning, but I do not have a strong opinion on them. Elementary OS has a very simple design, but I think sometimes it is oversimplified. For example, files have no settings at all. There is simply no settings button. You can change only what you see. I know you can do some settings, but you either need to use some third-party apps like dconf editor, or you need to edit the configuration files manually. Terminal has more settings, scale and color, that's it. No way to change the font or create different profiles. I also would like to stop on the Elementary OS payment system. It works with the model pay as much as you want. You can also pay zero. On the one hand, I like this move and I think all distros should provide a similar option. This will help to support the developers and eventually both the developers and the users will benefit from it. On the other hand, I don't know how it is perceived by new users. New users have heard that Linux is great because it is free. They installed Elementary OS and then they see the payment requirement when they want to install some apps. It may not be that obvious for new users that one can place zero into the price field. Maybe having an install and fund button side by side would be a little more fair. All in all, Elementary OS is a great distribution and I don't regret installing it on my laptop. It does have many issues, but luckily most of them can be easily fixed as you can learn from my video on 15 things to do after installing Elementary OS. It is on your screen right now. Click on it to watch. Thank you.